Welcome to a lesson on multiplying whole numbers. Here we have 3 times 2, and the first thing we should notice is there are many ways to write multiplication. All of these mean 3 times 2, and we can see the product is equal to 6. 3 times 2 means we have 3 groups of 2, or 3 copies of 2. And you can also think of multiplication as scaling. Well, if we have 3 groups of 2, there's one group of 2, there's a second group of 2, and there's a third group of 2. And to show the groups, we could even circle these. So there's one group of 2, there's a second group of 2, and there's a third group of 2. So we can see when we have 3 groups of 2, we have a total of 6. Now you might also notice that if we view this as 2 groups of 3, the total is still 6. And this is due to the fact that when we change the order of multiplication, the answer or the product is still the same. 3 times 2 is equal to 2 times 3. This is a property we'll take a look at in just a moment. Now for some vocabulary, the numbers being multiplied together are the factors, so 3 and 2 are the factors, and the product is the result or the answer when we multiply. So our product is equal to 6. Before we take a look at some more involved examples, let's go and take a look at a couple properties. Multiplication is commutative. And what that means is that we can change the order of the multiplication and the product will be the same. And from the previous example, we know that 3 times 2 is equal to 6, and so is 2 times 3. And then lastly, if we have 0 times a number, or a number times 0, the product is always 0. Now if you're just learning how to multiply, this multiplication table may be very helpful, and you might want to make one of your own. The way this works is we have the factors in red and the products in blue. For example, to find the product of 7 and 6, here's a 7 and here's a 6, we just determine where this row and this column intersect. Like this. So 7 times 6 is equal to 42. And this does occur twice in this table due to the commutative property of multiplication. Meaning if I select the 6 from this row and the 7 from this column, of course the product is still 42. So you may find this table very helpful. Let's go and take a look at some examples. If we want to find the product of 43 and 6, we're first going to write this in vertical form. Now we're going to multiply the 6 by the 3. Well, 6 times 3 would be 18. So we'll write down the 8 in the 1's column and carry a 1 over to the 10's column. Now we're going to multiply the 6 times the 4. Well, 6 times 4 is 24, but then we have to add this 1, so we'll have 25. So 43 times 6 is equal to 258. Let's try 21 times 32. You can view this as two problems. We're going to multiply the 2 times the 21, and then the 3 times the 21. So we're going to have 2 times 1, that's 2, and then 2 times 2, that'll give us 4. Now we are going to multiply by the 3, but since this is in the tens column, we're really multiplying by 30. So what we have to do is add a 0 to the ones column, so this first product will be in the tens column. 3 times 1 would be 3. Notice this is really 30 times 1, and that's why we have to have this 0 here. And then we have 3 times 2, that would be 6. And now we add the columns. We have 2, 7, and 6. So this product is 672. Let's go ahead and try another one. Notice here we have 27 times 3,425. It's usually easier to multiply if the second factor has less digits. And since multiplication is commutative, we can change the order of this multiplication. So we're going to write this as 3,425 times 27. Notice now we just have to multiply by the 7 and then the 2. So now we'll start by multiplying by the 7. Well, 7 times 5, that would be 35. So you write the 5 down and we carry a 3. Now we have 7 times 2, that's 14, plus the 3, that would be 17. Carry the 1. 7 times 4 would be 28, plus the 1, that would be 29. So we write the 9 down and carry the 2. And now we have 7 times 3, that's 21, plus 2, that's 23. And now we multiply by the 2, but since this 2 is in the tens column, we have to start by adding a 0 in the ones column. And we have 2 times 5, that's 10, so we write down the 0 and carry the 1. 2 times 2 would be 4, plus the 1, that would be 5. Then we have 2 times 4, that would be 8. And then we have 2 times 3, that would be 6. And now we add the columns. This would be 5, 7, 14, so we carry a 1. This would be 1 plus 3 plus 8, that's 12. Carry the 1. That would be 1 plus 2 plus 6, that would be 9. Our product is 92,475. Let's take a look at a word problem. You notice that your favorite restaurant is offering lunch for $4 per person, tax included, instead of the regular $6 per person. As a result, you decide to buy lunch for your 5 friends. If you have $30, how much money will you have left after lunch? Of course, you are going to eat too. So if you're going to pay for your 5 friends and yourself, you'll have to purchase 6 lunches at $4. So the cost of the lunch would be 6 times 4, which is equal to $24. So if you have $30 and lunch is going to cost you $24, you need to find the difference. So the amount of money you will have left will be $30, the amount of money you have, minus the cost of the lunch, which is $24, which will equal $6. You will have $6 left after you buy lunch for you and your friends. That'll do it for this video. Thank you for watching.